Hello everyone, this is the second part of the poem. In today's lecture, we will focus on the detailed line-by-line explanation. So coming straight to the topic, My Mother at 66 is a touching poem written by the Indian poetess Kamala Das. In this poem, she describes her feeling of love and attachment towards her aging mother. The text of the poem will appear right there on your screen. I'm reading out the lines. Just follow the lines carefully. So the lines are, Driving from my parents' home to Cochin, last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me. Doors open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain. Here corpse means a dead body. Okay, so the poet is conveying her own story. So the poet is telling that once the poet went to visit her mother, she was on her way back to the airport to return to Cochin, okay, which is also pronounced as Kochi in Indian English. Okay, Cochin is also pronounced as Kochi. It was Friday morning. She was driving back to the airport. Her mother was sitting beside her at the back of the car. Okay. The poetess looked at her mother very closely and carefully, which present her image before the readers, before us. Okay. Her mother had dozed off to sleep. She was sleeping. And her aging face was smoky in color like that of her ash. Okay. Her mouth was open and she resembled like a dead body, which is also called as corpse. Okay. The poet realized that her mother was getting very old. She felt the pain and sympathy for her. According to her, her mother needed love, affection and care. So, here the poet is showing a kind of typical love and affection which is present in a mother-daughter relationship. Okay, so follow the next lines, that she was as old as she looked, but soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of their homes. Okay, so in these lines, the poetess realized that her mother had grown old. She felt the pain for her. Okay. In order to come out of that gloom and the sadness as well, the poet shifted her glance and looked out of the car's window. Okay. She just diverted herself and looked out of the car window in order to drive out the negative feelings. Okay. In order to drive out the negative feelings which she is feeling inside. Okay, inside, which she is thinking very deep. Okay, which the negative feeling she is going through. She just wanted to divert herself from this kind of feelings. She changes her sad mood and the scene outside the window is a growing life and energy. Okay, what was the scene she was seeing? So, she tried to get rid of the sad thought by diverting her thoughts towards the trees outside. She was seeing some trees, young trees. Okay, the young trees, although stationary, seemed to be running very fast as though they were sprinting. Okay, as they were moving. Okay, they were in a car. Okay, they were going to the airport. And when the poetess looked outside, okay, she was waving, she was seeing some young trees, which was full of life. She also saw some children, okay, running out of their houses, spilling out of their houses, means running out of their houses into the playground. Okay, so they also symbolizing youth. Okay, all these things were full of life and energy, contrary to the aging face of her mother, which was just a kind of a contrast to her mother, because at the same time, her mother was very old, very weak, and simultaneously at that very moment, she was weaving some pictures. Pictures, what kind of picture? They were a lively picture, okay. A she was weaving some young trees, okay, children, and they were symbolizing life, vitality and youth, okay, and energy as well. So it was a kind of contrast between the mother and the pictures she was weaving, okay, because her mother was very old and at the same time she was weaving some energetic youthful children, youth, and some young trees as well. So this was a kind of a contrary to her mother. So she also saw children running out of the houses into the playgrounds, okay. It was also acting as a contrary to the aging mother. It was a kind of a contrast, okay, you can say, who was sitting next beside to her, who was sitting beside her, okay. They were all symbolized energy, life, happiness, youth and vitality, okay. They were symbolizing a kind of energetic, okay, world, a lively and happy and youthful world, okay. So coming to the next lines, but after the earpost security check, standing a few yards away, I looked again at her, wan, pale as a late winter's moon, and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear, but all I said was, see you soon, Amma. All I did was smile and smile and smile. Okay. So this is the last paragraph of the poem. It is a very short poem. So in this lines, the poetess continues to convey to the readers that when she reached the airport, she finished with the security check, okay, and stood a few yards away from her mother. It indicates departure and separation as well, which creates a kind of melancholy, okay, a pain, okay. As she bids goodbye to her mother, the image of the old, wan and worn out strikes her again, okay. Old, worn and worn out means the face of her mother, okay. That was very dull, that was very weak, and it was also very pale, okay. She glanced very closely, she noticed her mother very closely. Her mother's aging face one more time, which looked so dull, weak and pale. Okay, her mother face was looking dull, weak and pale because it was full of wrinkles and some lines due to the old age. Just like the moon in winter season, which seems to have lost all its strength. So her mother face was compared to the winter's moon. Okay. Her mother's face was compared to the winter's moon. It is also acting as a kind of figure of speech, okay, which I will be discussing in my next lecture. So the poetess mother's face has been compared to the winter's moon, and which seems to have lost all its strength. Okay, the face which the audience just had a look, okay, the mother's face which the audience had a look, it was a kind of dull face, a pale face, and her mother was also looking very weak. So the poet compares her mother to the late winter's moon, as the moon in the winters is not shining, okay, the moon in the winters, the moon is not shining, and even her mother's face had also lost her youth and shine as well, okay. That is why she is comparing her mother's face to the winter's moon, as her mother was getting older and weaker day by day, okay. As the time was passing by, her mother was getting older and weaker day by day. The poet feels the fear of separation just as she used to feel during her childhood, okay. The poetess, that is Kamala Das, is feeling a kind of very fearful to lose her mother. She feels a fear of separation as she used to feel in her childhood, during her childhood. As a child, she could not bear the pain of separating from her mother. That feeling has made her insecure. Okay, when she was a child, she was always having a kind of fear that she will get separated from her mother. And that same fear, that familiar ache, okay, that same fear she is facing right now. But now, the loss would be permanent. Why permanent? As her mother was about to die, that is why the loss will be permanent. And she would lose her mother forever, as her mother is growing old very soon. Okay. The poet feels that maybe this is the last time that she is seeing her mother, and this thought is haunting her. Okay. So what the poet is thinking is that it is the last time that she is seeing her mother. When next time she will visit her mother will be no more. Okay. So this is the last time she is seeing her mother, and this thought is haunting her. Okay. She tries to hide her fear. She then says that she would soon see her mother again. She says to the reader as well as to her mother that she will, when she will visit her mother next time, okay, she will soon see her mother again by hiding her fear. Okay. She says so because she doesn't want to lose her mother. Okay. And she also doesn't want to share her inner feelings with her mother, that what are the kind of thoughts she is going through. Okay. The poet did not express her feelings, as she is struck with the horror and pain of losing her. As I told you, that poet is very fearful to lose her mother, and she is in pain that one day she will lose her mother, and next time when she will come to visit her mother, hope that she will not be able to meet her mother. Okay. She is so pained that it is natural for her to cry, but keeping a brave front, she hides her tears and she smiles. Okay. She bids farewell to her mother, as in the last paro, she bids her mother farewell. She says a goodbye to her mother, and keeping her hope of seeing her again alive the next time. Okay. She smiled and said, "See you soon, Amma," because she was hoping that next time when she will visit her mother, she will be able to meet her mother. Okay, her mother will be alive next time. And that was a kind of hope. Okay, she was just keeping hope that everything will be fine, and next time when she will come and visit her mother, she will definitely see her mother and just spend her time with her mother. Okay. She hides her sorrow, and as she does not want to create a painful environment for her mother, and conveys her that as she is enjoying her life, similarly her mother should also be happy and enjoy her life. And that is the only reason she doesn't share her feelings with her mother, because she just wanted her mother to be happy, to enjoy her life, so that she doesn't share her inner feelings, inner thoughts with her mother. What kind of thought she is going through, that she is thinking that after next time when she will come, she won't be able to meet her. Okay. This feeling she doesn't share with her mother, because she just want her mother to be happy and to be at peace. Okay. So because she wanted that her mother should leave and they could meet again soon. The poem revolves around the theme of advancing age. It's very important that the poem is revolving around a kind of advancing age and the fear to loss and separation. Okay. And the fear of loss and separation is a main theme of the poem. It is one of the major, I will not say that it is only the main theme. It's one of the main theme of the, one of the major theme of the poem, that is a advancing age and loss and separation. Okay. Because each and every individual face this kind of thing in their life. Okay. The advancing age as well and the kind of loss and separation and the fear of a loss and separation each and every individual just face in their life. Okay, so that is why this is the main theme of the poem. So it is a kind of a sentimental poem. It is having a sentimental account of mother's approaching death, approaching end, which is very near. Okay, through the eyes of a daughter. Okay, अपने बेटी की आँख से दिखाया गया है, एक बेटी की आँख से दिखाया गया है अपने उसकी मदर का अप्रोचिंग एंड को, अप्रोचिंग डेथ को, जो अप्रोचिंग डेथ मीन्स अप्रोचिंग एंड मीन्स द डेथ विच इज़ वेरी नियर. ओके, इट इज़ अ शॉर्ट पोएम, टचेज अपॉन द थीम ऑफ प्योर बॉन्ड, द वेरी प्योर बॉन्ड इन दिस वर्ल्ड, द बॉन्ड ऑफ ए बिटवीन अ मदर एंड अ डॉटर. ओके, इन द बैकड्रॉप ऑफ अ नॉस्टैल्जिया एंड फियर. So in this poem, the pure bond has been discussed, the bond of a mother and daughter, and it also gives us a kind of a nostalgia feeling, a feeling of a nostalgia. In the last video lecture, I was already told you the meaning of nostalgia, that thinking about the past memories, thinking about the past things, and just going through those past memories. Okay, the memories can be of happiness, or the memory can be of sadness. It only depends upon the situation, and that is why this poem is the also the theme of the poem. One of the theme of the poem is also nostalgia. So the bond of a mother and daughter and their relationship is focused in this poem, along with the backdrop of nostalgia, the past memories. Okay, past memories, why? The precious time she used to spend with her mother. Okay, she was also thinking the precious time she used to spend with her mother. After her mother will die, she won't be able to spend her life like that. She won't be able to spend her time with her mother anymore. Okay, that is why poetess Kamala Das also focused on the theme of nostalgia, and also the nostalgia as well as the fear of loss and separation. Okay, nostalgia of the past, the time spent with her mother. Okay, the precious time which she has spent with her mother, and the fear of future without her. Okay, the fear of future without her means the fear of loss and separation from her mother, the fear of the permanent loss and separation with her mother. Okay, because as soon as her mother will die, okay, there will be a kind of a, she will lose her mother. Okay, and there will be a kind of a permanent separation from her mother. So for now, we are done with the detailed analysis as well the critical appreciation of the poem. As you all just can see, the poem is too short. So just we had done the detailed explanation in a single lecture. Okay, so no more detailed line by line explanation had been done in details. Okay. So I don't think any kind of extra explanation is needed, because the poem is too short, and I just explained you all the line by line, as well as I have given you a kind of a critical appreciation analysis kind of thing. Okay, and so just go through the chapters, especially the poem My Mother at 66, this one which I'm doing right now, and just revise those things, and just go through the lectures one by one, revise the lectures. If anything is not clear to you, just play the video, play the lectures again and again. Okay, I just made it very simple so that each and every one can understand. Though I'm not speaking in Hindi, I must just want to say you that this, I'm not using bilingual. Okay, I'm not using the bilingual mode, because see, to explain English in Hindi is not right. Okay, so some of the tough words I will just convey you in a Hindi. Don't worry about it. And I'm just giving you a kind of explanation is a very simple manner, in this very simple words, in a very simple way, so that each and everyone out there can understand my language as well as my words. Okay, so meet you all soon in my next video lecture with many more topics related to this poem. It's not complete yet. We will be doing many more topics from this poems. Okay, so keep learning, enrich your knowledge, stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to get the latest updates and share with your friends definitely. And surely tap on the bell icon so that you get the notification as soon as I upload my video lectures. Okay, bye bye, take care, goodbye.